Last Buddha and the amazing religion of Buddhism.
Welcome back to the Buddhism Hotline. We just had a major technical problem with the program that Chad has caused. Guys, do not ever get Spectrum Internet. Spectrum Internet is terrible, and they failed the Buddhism Hotline tonight. They destroyed our internet connection, and they destroyed our ability to teach Buddhism across the world. But we just fixed the problem, and we're back on the air. Everything is working fine now, and we're here tonight to teach Buddhism. Banjo Steve, I want to ask you real quick what you were doing in the bathroom for so long.
I had to take a leak, man.
Had to take a leak? Okay, but what were you smoking? Because I smell something in there.
I don't think you want to smell what's in the bathroom. So.
What the Buddha did you do in there?
I'm on a vegetable diet. But I still eat meat and shrimp.
Buddha wanted this program to turn back on. So we're here still tonight on the program to teach Buddhism. Everything's working now. We're going to teach Buddhism. They're not going to stop us from teaching Buddhism. We're going to teach Buddhism tonight. We're going to tell them about Buddhism. And we're going to spread the word of Buddhism across the world. Okay? So let's go ahead and get a call on the air. Let's get a call on the air now that the program is up and running. Hello? Hello?
Hello, Jonathan.
Hello. Welcome to the Buddhism Hotline. I'm here with Banjo Steve, and we're going to teach Buddhism tonight now that the program is working.
This microphone smells.
Microphone smell.
Yeah.
I didn't do anything. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, ma'am. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi, Jonathan. I want to wish you a happy birthday. I didn't get to catch a stream.
Well, you already missed my day of birth. My day of birth was not yet. It was on Sunday.
Oh, right. When Jesus risen, right?
We do not say the J-word on this program.
Sorry, I'm in Johnny.
We don't say the J word. That's against Buddhism. That's not the right religion.
I have dementia.
Okay, well, it's Buddha. It's Buddha. It's Buddha. That's Buddha.
Okay.
Do you have a question about Buddhism or not?
What is today's Buddhist teaching?
We're just talking about Buddhism in general. We're talking about the whole entire religion tonight.
Yeah, the message is if you got a pair, eat a pear, and if you got a pear, share a pear.
What does that
mean?
What does that mean? That's not a Buddhism command.
I'm pretty sure it's some kind of...
I'm sorry, what did you say, ma'am?
Find your new co-host.
What about him?
I'm Banjo Steve.
I'm sorry? Can you speak up, young lady?
Did you find him on a senior center?
Very funny. No, I found him on a website on Facebook. I found him on this acting web. I was trying to find...
Well, my agent was saying that I could go up and I could talk about my new album, Bat Soup Crazy.
Turn your microphone up. I can't understand anything you're saying.
I don't know. I was going to leave, and then my publicist was like, just go in there and do this show. Like, you already said you would do it. I was like,
man. This is a serious program.
Such garbage. But
this is a serious program.
I don't know. Mulright ain't going to be here for like 90 more minutes.
This is a serious program.
I figured I might as well hang it out.
This is a serious program. This is a serious program. What up, though, Jonathan? What's going on there? What's going on, Banjo Steve? How you doing tonight, there, you big old pimp player baller?
He's not a pimp. He's a Buddhist. He's here to teach Buddhism.
Yeah.
Whatever you say.
No, he's here to be professional. So don't make this a funny thing. It's not supposed to be funny.
Yeah. It's going to be a fun thing. It's always a fun thing around here with you there, Jay Diddy.
My name's not Jay Diddy. My name's Jonathan Hills.
I tell you. This looks like a cheap porn set, doesn't it?
It's not a porn set.
Oh, man. Hey, don't you, only thing you think of when you walk on that set is chicken, chicken, wow, wow, chicken, chicken, wow, wow.
That's racist. That's racist.
That's how you do it. Yeah.
Yeah, you're being racist right now. Why are you talking about chicken on a Buddhism hotline?
Supposed to shake it, but not break it.
No. What's racist is the fact that the female that you're supposed to have on here, that's clickbait. This is clickbait episode.
I thought it was a woman, too. You told me you were a woman. Your person told me a woman was coming on tonight.
I thought he was a woman. I don't know.
I got clickbaited. I got clickbait. I thought.
Well, you know.
I got tricked.
You know Jay Diddy is a woman because
my name's not Jay Diddy though. I didn't diddy anybody. There's no diddying going on here tonight on the Buddhism Hotline. I'm here to teach Buddhism.
Did,
that's it.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, diddied all over the place.
No, I didn't diddy anybody.
A woman.
Yeah.
We were expecting a woman. And we got this long-haired character up there.
Oh, my
goodness. What up? Banjo Steve from Florida. You know how we do it.
This is... Okay, you know what, caller? Listen to me right now. I thought I was going to get a young professional Buddhist woman, and I got this...
I played a banjo.
...guy who looks like he just got out of a failed rock band, okay?
Or a successful one.
No,
you know?
No.
It's pretty much the same outfit.
I'm going to turn him into a Buddhist, though. That's my goal. He says he's a Buddhist. I don't think he's a Buddhist. I think he's a fake Buddhist.
My publicist said if I just played along, hey, it'd be good for the album, so...
I'm not responding to that.
I think he's talking to you.
You're going to respond to it.
I'm not going to respond to it, actually. That's not what I'm going to do.
I'm going to respond to it. You're judging him because of how he looks? Aren't you being a little bit prejudiced right there? That's not.
Am I being prejudiced? I hired him because I thought he was a woman and I got catfish, obviously. That's not. I'm the one.
You got catfish, misled. You got bamboozled.
Yes, I got bamboozled. I got tricked.
Bamboozled. You got who?
The woman looked like Megan Fox too. She was a good looking woman. She was a good looking woman on your profile.
That's my sister. She lives in a.
Why would you put your sister as your profile picture?
She lives in a trailer in Pinellas Park.
Why would you put your sister on the profile picture? First of all, why would you put your sister on the profile picture? That makes zero sense.
Well, there's a song about my sister living in a trailer.
Hey John, the stream is occasionally lagging.
No, we fixed that problem. Thank you, though.
Also, can we denounce this new UI bullshit? We can't even donate anymore without having to go through a million steps to get to it.
That was an old donation. That was an old donation while we were having a problem with the program. But now the program is fixed. Everything is fine now. Thank Buddha. Thank Buddha that he fixed the program. So everything's working. Donations are working. Calls are working. Everything.
This song is an epic banger.
This could be serious.
It's as good as Buddha Star.
This could be a serious song about Buddhism. So people
give
your head.
People give you tips on like, you should get some microphone cleaner for this, man. It smells like fucking people have been breathing this.
Do not
this
swear
shit
on my program.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry.
I told you it's a Buddhism
this
hotline.
This smells like dog shite.
This is a Buddhism hotline. Okay? Can you talk about Buddhism?
I could try to.
What is this?
That's a honor roll from.
What is this? Is this a Buddhist song?
Yeah, pretty much. It's about finding yourself like stuck and not really being able to change things on your own and find the acceptance so that you can change things.
Guess I got no place to go.
Is this you? This sounds like you.
It is me.
This is your music? This is your music?
Ain't no mechanics. My music, yeah. I don't know, but I was on a roll. See, it's called Honor Roll. But it's about like being on a roll in life, and then things are just stopped in your progression. Oh, you find yourself having to change and manifest and grow.
This is actually not bad.
Guess I got nowhere thanks, man. To go.
This is Buddhist too. It sounds Buddhist.
Better loosen up my load.
You know, it's like we carry all these things on us, and we gotta just kind of like depart with them and keep going. You know.
That's very Buddhist.
And yeah.
That's very Buddhist of you.
And then I think the next line is all about, you know, thinking about things that happen and realizing not everything's always your fault. And, like, you know, sometimes you got to just accept what's happening.
We have a situation where we have a...
That was actually a good song. I have to say right now, I'm impressed. Okay? I thought you were a scuffed, failed musician. I have to say, that was actually kind of Buddhist. The lyrics, what you were just describing...
It's there, man.
You could
man.
Be the next Buddhist rock star. You could be the next Kurt Cobain, but a Buddhist Kurt Cobain. You could be the next Oprah.
I was thinking I could be like the most humblest Buddha rock star ever. You know, like yeah, like we could have T-shirts, be like most humblest Banjo Steve, no BS, and that's the name of the band, an OBS band.
I'm the
so, yeah, man, and we get you know
because we can work. We can work together right now. Okay. We can work together, and if you get famous, then I get some of the profit on that. That's how that works.
That seems fair. I
can
do a contributing thing. I get your microphone and smell like someone's butt.
No one smells like a... Hello?
Hello.
Hi. I want to ask, how did you arrange this? How did you arrange this guy before going to the show? Did you contact him by video or voice conference?
No, I found him on some weird website.
My publicist was reaching out.
Before you arrange him to be the host, you need to have an exact live image, like his voice or a picture or video conference. You can't just assume, oh, this is a girl, and then next thing you know, it's actually a guy, because you just lied to us.
Well, though, I didn't lie. I got misled. Hold on. I'm the one who got misled here. I didn't lie.
Everything's a lie at first.
I was lied to. I'm the victim here.
An idea is a lie until it manifests.
Why did you pretend to be a woman on the phone? When I talked to you, you were talking in a woman voice, too. You thought I only wanted you because you're a girl?
No, I think that must be my publicist. She was like, she probably sent like a hot photo. Be like, hey, you know. She knows what kind of organization he's running here.
What?
We got one, the Ray Rich call.
Hang up the call. Hang up the call. That's a joke. They were making a sexual thing. That was sexual.
Okay.
That was sexual. This is a serious program. Banjo doesn't need.
That's not a woman. That's clearly a biological male who's not dysphoric and hasn't modified his body to resemble a biological female.
What is that noise? Chad, turn that off. Turn that noise down. I can't hear.
This is how you get people to watch your show?
I didn't do this. Someone put this on the system. I have no control over this. They're trying to give me a seizure or something. Oh, my Buddha. I didn't put that on the air, Steve. I didn't put that on the air. Why do you think everything's my fault? I have control over everything. Chad is the one running the software. They donated on the system.
Yeah.
My ears are repulsed right now. My ears are repulsed.
That's worse than the Black Clash, man.
The Black Clash?
They're like the worst punk rock band that ever existed.
Look, I'm not into punk. That's devil worshipping music. I'm not into devil worshipping music.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to celebrate devil worshipping music on this program. Banjo, do you sing devil worshipping music too?
Nah, man. I think, I sing about, like, you know, thoughts and philosophy and stuff, you know?
Well, I'm all into philosophy. I'm a Buddhist. I know everything about.
Yeah.
Nirvana. And hello?
Oh, fucking hell.
I'm sorry. Are you okay? You sound a little bit funny. Okay. Caller, what are you doing? Fix your microphone before you call into this program and waste our time. We're Buddhists here.
Hey, there's a person.
There's a person that's talking. We can hear them talking. We're talking to them.
Hello?
Hello, I can hear you, caller. I can hear you. Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you. I just have a quick question about your co-host, shall we say?
Yes, yes.
Am I a co-host?
I'm here to answer your question, and I'm gonna tell it on the Instagram that are the program.
You can't spell co-host with co and ho, or you can't spell it out.
I'm sitting in my prison cell right now, and I got a.
You're shitting in your prison cell.
We're back on the program right now, guys. Tune in on YouTube right now. We're back on the air. Thank you.
This guy's shitting in his prison cell.
Why
is Chris Jericho on your program? Come on, Jonathan. I thought you hated WWE.
Are you involved in WWE?
I usually get Thor.
Are you involved in WWE?
Wait,
they say Thor a lot, but not in shape Thor.
Isn't WWE a sin?
Yes, it absolutely is a sin. Are you involved in WWE? I'm posting on the answer. Are you involved in WWE?
No, I'm not involved in WWE.
I'm just saying you have Chris Jericho.
Made some
WWE,
but not WWE.
We didn't do a background check. I thought it was a woman. I'm trying to figure out right now. I'm researching right now.
I don't know.
They just said I can talk about my album.
I'm looking up Chris Jericho right now.
So.
That is Chris Jericho.
I'm looking up Chris Jericho right now.
That is Chris Jericho.
Yeah. I like how low grade everything is. That's pretty cool. Yeah. helps keep things affordable.
Your audio is so scuffed, my guy. Take the microphone away from your mouth, you fat piece of crap.
Whoa! Hang up the call! Hang up the call! Hang up the call right now!
No, no!
Steve, are you okay, Steve? Are you okay?
It's a Buddha show, man.
I would never go that low. That is too low. That is too low. We don't say things about physical. And first of all, I don't even think you look like this guy at all. I don't even think you look like this guy, okay? Honestly. You guys need to come up with some better stuff here, okay? You know, have some class to you. Have some class to you, okay? Are you okay? You look a little bit like you're coping right now. Like you're smiling, but you're like in deep down inside, something hurt you today. Are you hurt?
No. Not actually.
White stuff on your pants.
That is just a little
from
bit
from sexual intercourse.
I
hope not.
Might be.
What?
I actually think it's from.
It might be.
I don't know. It's just. Random white stuff on my pants. He said
it might be. You know. That's a little bit suspicious. That's a little bit suspicious.
I mean, I'm just saying.
What? Who are you calling fat? Who are you calling fat? Guys, stop. Bully. Banjo's teeth. He's a half-stuffed artist. He has potential. I can make it good. What is this?
I've got more chins than Chinatown.
What is this? This guy's Irish. The Mormons. No, not the Mormons. What was it? The people that live off the land. What are they called? The
Amish?
The Amish. Yeah, he's an Amish.
Amish
Weird
people
Weird Al
Yankovic
is an Amish. No, Amish people are evil.
Oh, yeah. I mean.
You agree with me on that, right?
I don't know.
Do you know anything?
Not really.
Are you high?
Nah, but, you know, like, I grew up in Florida, so we just like, kind of hung out
Florida
a lot.
Man.
Yeah.
Hi, how you guys
that's
doing?
That's a good thing. Hello?
Hi, Jonathan. How you doing?
We've had a lot of technical problems tonight, but we're back. Things are working now. And Banjo Steve, you know, I'm going to be honest, his music's not that bad, okay? It's okay. It's okay.
It's not.
Because if I...
It makes me money.
Your lyrics to be more Buddhist friendly, and once you do, you're gonna go viral. I'll tell you right now, you're gonna get viral, sensationship. You're gonna get millions of views, and you're gonna do a contract with us. You're gonna work for us.
Yeah, we'll see. 70-30
split.
New girl co-host.
Well, I thought it was a girl too. I thought it was a girl too. But you know what? At the same time, this could be our next talent right here. Okay, this could be the next talent.
Have you asked Steve how he identifies yet?
How do you do it? I did not ask that actually.
As an alien.
Wait, are you being funny right now? There's millions of genders out there, and I think it's completely.
Yeah,
Are you being serious?
If he identifies as the girls, and it's a new girl code.
He said he identifies as an alien. Are you being funny? Are you being serious?
I guess an alien could be whatever. So you know.
I think you're trying to be funny right now, Steve. It sounds like you're trying to be funny right now. That's how I'm taking it right now.
No, that'd be funny. I just talk about you.
You think you're a funny guy, don't you? You think it's a comedy club?
Well, you know.
But it's not a comedy club. There's children watching this.
Good.
Caller, he said he identifies as an alien, but I would take that with a grain of salt because I think he's being disrespectful right now, to be honest with you.
I think he might be. Look, the reason I called in is I would like to be converted to Buddhism.
You want me to convert to Buddhism live in the air?
Yeah, how you do that?
Because you might start converting people to Buddhism soon, so you need to learn. Ready, caller? Are you ready?
Yeah, I mean, Y2J, feel free to join in.
So put your right hand there.
Gotcha.
And repeat after me. Say, I believe.
I believe.
In the holy, holy name.
In the holy, holy name.
The one that shrines above all others.
The one that shrines above all others.
The holy, holy name.
The holy, holy name.
Of Buddha.
Of the tribal chief Roman Reigns.
Hang up the call. Hang up the call. That's WWE. That's WWE. What are you? Why are you taking? Get that camera on my face.
That's a pretty good angle there.
Get that camera on my face. I did not agree to be Photoshopped. I did not agree to that.
Yeah, you know.
You're full of yourselves. Do you think you're the next big thing?
Well, I mean, I think I'm the best. I'm the best banjo player in the world, but.
without
I say that humbly.
You're going to be nothing, though. I have the numbers to back it up. You can become famous
That's
with me.
That's true. I do need some numbers. But by your check me out. Like, find Banjo, B-A-N-J-O-E, Steve on, like...
We don't do shout-outs. They're free. We don't do free.
Oh, yeah, but, you know, if they want to further their education... aside from and for, what were you guys? You had a question. I thought
we're gonna do a contract.
Gallantry here. Steve, is this you?
Steve, is this you? Hold on. There's a video, and they're asking Steve. Steve, is this you in the video?
Oh my god! It's what so is good this? To see you,
Steve.
Give me your cuddly little rascal.
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Whoa! That's kid on the TV. That looks a little bit suspicious right there. Steven, they're saying I don't think that's Steven because, guys, Steven.
Master, hey, it's Thor again. You know, the God of Thunder? Yeah, listen, Thor, buddy, if you don't log off this game immediately,
look,
I'm gonna
guys,
I to your house, come
stop
down that
calling him WWE. Stop.
That's not WWE.
What is that?
Just go cry to your father. But
what is that?
That's Thor, man.
What is Thor?
Fine, why?
What is Thor?
Thor. You look like Melton. Like when you stub your toe. But you're like, you're eating like sweet
so
food and be like,
that's
Thor,
at his expense right now. Why do you have to make so many jocks?
It's kind of like when you wake in the morning and you go to the store and it's like,
that's not him.
You're not feeling very
that's
good.
That's not him. That's not him. Okay. You guys don't even understand. Guys, that he's coming here tonight because he wants money, but I'm also going to make it into something good. We're going to turn this into, hello?
Yes, I was disconnected earlier, but I was the one who was saying that you were a very big inspiration to me.
You're welcome. I appreciate that.
Yes, but unfortunately, because of becoming a Buddhist, I lost my job, unfortunately, because I worked at the Bronx Zoo, and they caught me trying to titty fucking orangutan.
What are you talking about? Are you being serious right now? Are you making a
fuck? Who hasn't been there? I feel you. I feel you. Yeah, so.
What do you mean you feel him? He just said. It looks like you've been out of the league for a while.
You know, no, I'm good, man.
Well, you look a little bit rusty.
Ah, I'm lucky, man. I got a beautiful woman.
You have you have a woman that likes you?
Yeah, it's crazy.
For who you are?
For me. It's awesome.
Find that hard to believe, honestly. I really find.
I don't know. It's crazy.
Are you paying her?
No. I just do my thing, man.
I honestly don't believe you.
You don't have to.
I think you're a loser.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna make you into somebody. That's the thing. Well, I'm trying to say. I'm not trying to hurt your feelings.
I don't think my feelings really could be hurt.
I'm trying to make.
I think when you find yourself in a certain place where you can just be you. And you realize that there's going to be like and dislike. There's yin and there's yang. There's up and there's down.
Yin and yang.
There's all around. And then there's the spherical force of the 12 different points, man. And then, like, you're just inside those vibrations. And that's just how you're riding it out. And however you may reflect, it is the opposite action to how someone else is reflecting.
It almost sounds like you're high.
Nah, man. What,
are you on drugs?
No, not at all, man.
This is like you're on some LSD, like you're in a different dimension. Like talking like birds are not real.
I think we are within a different dimension.
Do you think birds are real? Do you think birds are real?
I think that they can communicate to the dead and like, you know, they can sing back.
Witchcraft.
Nah, man, that's
witchcraft.
What they say. You ever have like a crow just like fly and like get on your car and you're like walking up and there's this like crow looking at you and you're like, what's up, crow? And the crow just is kind of like, you know, and it takes off, and you know, like, so there's that kind of thing going on, man. You just gotta, you know, be out there doing it, you know. That's what we do.
That went above my head. That went a little bit above my head.
It's a higher pay grade, man. You know,
this could be serious. I'm gonna bow my head. This could be a Buddhism song. Thank you very much for the Buddhism song.
I hosted a KKK meeting in the Buddhism Hotline headquarters.
No, all my South Side N-words that know me best. Wait, whoa. I still might have sex. Why? I made that bitch famous. For all the girls that got dick from Johnny.
Is this Hill. The Black Clash?
Cut out the music.
I did not say those words. Hold on a second. You know what ChatGPT is. You know what AI is. They have new technology. They can make people say things they didn't say.
Yeah, you can't really believe anything. Just like you could also do that in your brain manifestation.
Like,
for every is, there is a isn't, and every ain't, there was an are not. You know what I mean?
Well, I'm not involved with any terrorist organization or any people that dress up in white stuff. I'm not with it. It's ChatGPT. Do you know about the new technology, or are you not with the new wave?
Well, you know what they're saying, man. They're going to have, like, robots and stuff.
They have ChatGPT. They have technology now, Steve.
I wouldn't mind, like, a couple robots.
What?
You know, like, they could do, like, some robot stuff. That'd be helpful.
What does that have to do with Buddhism?
Well, if you had, like, less, like, stuff you really want to do, and then you had, like a robot that came out and did all the stuff you ain't want to do, then you'd have more time to do stuff that you did want to do. And then, like, if you want to be more Buddhist-like, you could have more time to do that, because, like, sometimes it's hard to fit that in a schedule. You know, like, you'll sit there and, like,
Buddhist? Wait, you know. About a Buddhist robot?
Well, no, it'd be like a assistant.
You're talking about, like, a Buddhist robot, like some kind of Buddhist robot. Hello?
I mean, I guess if it had a bald
Hello?
Head, I wasn't going to put hair
on
it.
On the air.
Yes, you're on the Buddhism hotline. This is Jonathan Hills.
Hi, what's up, Jonathan Hills? Who's this guy out to your left?
Well, he's a failed artist that I'm really now failed. Using to mutually benefit from, and we're gonna make a lot of sales. We're gonna make a lot of records. Buddhist superstar that's coming, guys.
Yeah, I'm still kind of trucking along.
We might have to rebrand
Banjo with an E though. Banjo.
Oh, what
Steve.
Do you think about Buddhist Steve?
Oh, okay, so he's a recording artist. What label were you signed to by any chance? Were you
I
signed to Matthew Bistock Productions.
I've released my own music, though. I have a record label that you could join right now.
We have a 3-album deal.
Yeah,
we just released one.
Yeah, John.
Do you know about Buddhist Plan? Do you know
Steve.
About the song Buddhist Plan? I released that song. Buddhist Plan? You know the song?
Can you like, hold off for a sec? I'm talking to Steve here. You're kind of interrupting him.
Yeah, he kind of does all that.
All right, thank you. Do you play instruments, or do you just sing?
I play electric banjo, guitar, ukulele, mandolin, sitar, bouzouki. I play the bass, drums, keyboard.
Bro, I've been trying to play bass and drums. I'm trying to buy myself an acoustic guitar.
What does this have to do with Buddhism?
Well,
this is a music conversation,
okay,
John.
But,
back
but,
off.
But,
in front.
But what does it have to do with Buddhism?
Well, the best thing you do is the finger exercises.
We'll
1, 2, 3, 4.
We'll get to Buddhism in
Are
a
you talking
second.
About fingering?
I'm just trying to talk about music.
Vaginas right now on the air?
Well, you know, it's actually, if you can play an instrument, well, you could probably do that pretty well, too.
What the Buddha are you talking about,
Steve? I've been trying to play the keyboard. Dude, come
You're
on,
You're talking
man.
About
I'm
fingering
talk
woman's genitalias right now.
The keyboard.
Dude, what are you talking
you mean,
about?
Dude,
I'm just talking
you,
about music.
You're
come
asking
on.
Him how to have oral penetration, how to have physical penetration with a woman with the hands.
What the hell are you
You're
talking
using
about?
Using music as a guise. It's all just it's a ruse. You're just doing this to ask him about sexual things. I know what you're doing.
That's
how to play the
true.
Banjo. It means how to finger a woman. I know what it means. I know what you guys are talking
I think
about.
It's all, I think it's all relative.
Wait, hold on, John.
No, I'm exposing
you
guys
like
right now.
Tension and release, build up.
That's sexual.
Gray matter
That's
in between
sexual.
White and black
That's
is
sexual.
All intertwining. It's like a big spherical thing, right? People like to think that music goes like this, but it's spiral. But not only is it spiral, it's spherical too. So
what are you talking about? I'm just talking about instruments,
no.
music.
No, shut
dude.
Him off.
Like, come
shut
on.
Him off. Shut him off, Chad.
It's you know.
You're talking about sex. Don't
no,
beat
no, no. It's
don't beat around the bush, please. Please.
That sounds a little sexual.
Bless Buddha. Tension, release, tension. What is this? Is this serious? Is this Buddhist? Is this Buddhist? what are you laughing at, Steve? What are you laughing at? What is this? What am I watching right now? What am I watching? A bunch of people getting high? Is that what I'm watching? A bunch of cartoons, characters getting high? Is this banjo music? You want to explain the composition of the music or something at least?
Nah, I don't really know what's going on.
Are you on drugs?
Nah.
Are you high too?
Nah, man, I must just
You're
like...
You're so like chill. You're so chilled out.
Yeah, well, you know, that's how we do it. It's kind of, you know... I just play a banjo, so... I can barely read. I just do my thing.
Dude, what song is this? If you're so smart, what song is this?
The Twisted Finkster, I think.
Wait, you actually know the song?
Yeah, I think that's what it is.
Hello?
Okay, I guess. Hello?
Hello? Hello. My name is Rajut, and I am from India. How are you?
I'm doing. I didn't know they had internet connection in India, to be honest.
Namaste and Buddha bless.
They actually have internet connection there? Wait, they actually have internet connection there?
Yes, we have Buddhism.
Well, we get a fax?
We have a printer. People can print messages on here. Buddhist-friendly messages.
Can you convert me, please?
Do you actually want to be converted to Buddhism right now, live in the air?
Yes, Buddha bless.
Okay, put your right hand in the air and say, I believe.
I believe.
In the holy, holy name.
In the holy, holy name.
The one, Steve, you want to do it with us?
Do I got to do it every time?
No, you don't have to do it. Are you a Buddhist?
I already did it, and I was going to check.
So you are a Buddhist?
I was going to just check my email real quick.
So you are a Buddhist?
Holy, holy name.
Yeah. Yeah, sure.
Say, I believe.
Continue.
Well, I'm sorry. I believe. In the holy, holy name.
In the holy, holy name.
The one that shrines above all others.
The one that shrines above all others.
Why are you talking like that? Why do you sound like that? Why do you sound like that?
The one that shrines above all others.
Why do you sound like that?
I'm Indian. Please continue.
I'm sorry. You're Indian, but you're almost making fun of people that work at 7-Eleven that work very hard in this country.
In the holy name of Rajiv Kapoor.
What are you? That's not a Buddhist. That's not a Buddhist. That is not a Buddhist. I don't even know why you're making up random filth on a Buddhism hotline. Okay, Banjo Steve came here tonight to become a superstar. And you're making this a bad look for him. We need to get his PR up. We need to get his PR up.
That's what we're trying to do.
We're trying to get you to become famous. So he can help me. It's a win-win.
Everybody wins.
It's a win-win-win-win. It's going to benefit both of us. I'm telling you right now. When you become famous, Jonathan's going to become famous too.
That's probably true.
That's a win-win.
That's probably true.
And we just got a printer today.
Oh, we got a fax. Look at that. Dude, I ain't seen anybody getting a fax in so long.
I know technology. I'm a technological person.
I can't read that far.
It says, Luigi Gianella says, I found out going through printers is more fun. My butthole is far raised right now. Jesus on my ball sack, bouncing Fat Thor, Chris Jericho, and Adam Copeland. I need my sucked, my bad Jeremy and Kenneth gone. Jonathan nude photos, holy anal, 6-6.
Can't really read that far.
You thought you could come on to this program and use my printer to put on filth? Anal sex? Look what I think they're looking up to you now, some kind of sex god. Because now they're donating things about sex.
I mean, people worship me.
How many times have you had sex today? Have you had sex today?
Well, yeah. But, you know, I mean, that's not really something I came here to talk about.
Did you come?
I'm here, ain't I?
You know, as for context, it gets Buddhism, though, right? It's in the book. It's in my book, Buddha Bless Me, Buddha Bless You, available for only $49.99 on whatsapbuddhismhotline.org. It says it's against the religion of Buddhism. Having as for contact is against the religion of Buddhism.
Are you saying you don't have sex?
I know. No, that's what I'm saying, Steve. That's exactly what I'm saying, actually.
Is that why your microphone smells like this?
Why do you think my microphone sounds like that? Because I don't have as for contact.
No, it's not sound. Smells. It's like, do you do weird stuff with this microphone?
Do you think I do sex? I just told you I don't.
I don't know, man.
Do you think this is a big sex orgy room? You think I just do sex all day? I'm not a saint. Do you see what I'm saying here?
There might be a difference between like cartoon rape and then like people rape is all I'm saying.
Why do you have to think so much? Why do you have to think about
everything? Well, you know, that's what we do. We just kind of think. I like to get, you know, out there and just kind of like start thinking about what I
have. But you know I'm a genius.
Well, that makes sense. Well, then you understand why I'd be thinking all the time.
No, I don't. You need to dumb yourself down a little bit. Okay, because I'm in a position of power right now. I'm the host of this program. Okay? So when I say things, you go with them. You don't question me. You don't question my authority. You don't ask me, is it really rape? Yes. Yes, I well, said Jonathan said.
I don't really respect authority.
Well, you should be on your knees for not in sexual way, well, not in a sexual way.
That's not what someone who doesn't respect authority would do. I just figure, you know, like, I don't really care. You know, I mean, y'all do your thing. I just do my thing. And then, you know, so that's how we do it, you know.
I just feel like you're high.
Nah, man. Nah.
You're so, like, zen.
I mean, I've been told that before.
You're so zen.
Ooh.
Hello? You're on the Buddhist Online. This is Jonathan Hills here with Banjo Steve.
Jonathan.
That's my name. That's my name.
Bring Mathis back.
I'm sorry?
Why did you rape Mathis?
Why did I rape who?
I mean, there's a lot of allegations going around nowadays.
There's a lot of false allegations because people are jealous that I'm in a position of power.
Hey, this kind of place right here seems like one of those spots where you have like...
Rape dungeon? You think it's a rape dungeon? If I was going to rape you, I would let you know I was going to rape you.
I'm just going to say it doesn't not look like a rape dungeon. Like...
I'm so...
If someone said, hey, what would a rape dungeon be? I'd say like, hey, go to this fucking Jonathan dude's place.
You just swore.
All right, well,
take
that off the record. Go to this dude Jonathan's like place.
You start bleeping him out with the
you know
software.
I wouldn't be surprised if the room there has like one of those like beds with like the chain on the arm on there.
What are you talking about?
I'm just saying. I'm not saying I know this is a rape dungeon. I'm just saying that this doesn't like make you feel like it's not one sometimes.
Do you really want to become famous? Are you sure you want to become famous?
I'm just gonna be me. That's kind of what we do.
So instead of an actual interesting co-host, you brought on Dollar Tree late 90s Jeff Bridges? He'll never be the Big Lebowski.
Okay. First of all, I don't even know who those people are. I'm not that old. I'm only 37.
Yeah, people like to think that I'm kind of like the dude. I like to think that the dude was maybe like me. So
I'm only 37.
It's just this kind of how we do the room, you know.
Is that
just kind of.
Are they insulting you?
Nah, man. I like that guy.
Late show talk show host. How old are you? Are you in your 50s, 60s?
I'm 73.
You're 73?
Yeah, man. See,
I take
good care of myself. I like carrot juice.
Getting up there.
You know, carrots are good. And
sounds
then,
like you're gonna kick the bucket soon.
Nah, I don't think so. I like to hit like 100 or something. Be pretty cool.
How are you handling the concept of death? Are you ready for that?
Well, I think we're all just kind of watching ourselves from our past, anyways. So like right now, it's just basically just a memory of then, but that would be the now of then. So you know, I'm just kind of riding through it. So you know, I probably ride again through a few times.
Right now, are you saying that this is all fake?
I'm not sure.
Buddha's real.
Okay.
But it's real. You don't believe in Nirvana? The second life?
I mean, you know, I liked a lot of their B-side tracks. You know, those are pretty good. And their main ones are good, too.
I'm happy with what happened to Kurt Cobain. You know why? He was a devil worshiper. That was a disgrace to Buddhism. You know how many people heard the song Nirvana or the band Nirvana and thought it was Buddhist related? It slandered the Buddhism community. It slandered the name of Buddha for so long. So when he died, you know, that was a blessing from Buddha. They slandered our religion. They made a whole band called Nirvana. It wasn't about Buddhism though. That's slander.
Oh, I didn't know Nirvana was Buddhist.
No, they're not Buddhist. That's what I'm saying, Steve. That's what I'm saying to you.
Is Buddhist Nirvana?
Yes.
I don't get it.
How do you not? You're not a Buddhist, are you?
I'm not really. I don't really read. You know what I mean. So, I think they're just doing their thing, and I mean, I like pears though. Like,
hello,
they're pretty good.
Hello.
I forgot to mention they also call me trying to masturbate in the tarantula.
Hang up the call. Hang up the call right now. Look what you're doing. Okay, you are egging them on right now. It's the way you conduct yourself, Steve.
Oh, I was just thinking something.
I know, but it's the sex jokes you make. It's making them say these outlandish things on a religious program about Buddhism.
I see.
Don't you think there's a correlation there?
Of what?
Of you. Steve, you're the common denominator.
Hmm.
I'm talking about sex.
I am the center of the universe.
Why do you keep talking about sex?
Because I think they all bow down to me.
What?
You know.
Why is Don Beveridge's dad on this stream? Is John getting his old co-host's parents on now or something?
Hold on. You're not related to Don Beveridge, are you?
I don't know what that means.
There's a... person that's been on my program named Don Beveridge. Are you related to him?
I don't know.
Okay.
I think we're all kind of related to each other in one way or another.
That's incest. That's disgusting. Okay. The only thing that's fine is the mom. If it's your mom, I believe that's motherly love. I think that's natural. I think it's okay.
You have sex with your mom?
No, I did not say that. But a kiss on the lip is not that bad. Okay, that's motherly love.
How long is the kiss?
There's different. There's a French, and the French is not anything bad. The French is a loving thing. It's an enduring thing.
Well, the French like people did give their kids wine.
I'm saying that it's not disgusting to kiss your mother on the lips. It's not bad. As a Buddhist, we believe in close affects to our family.
I wouldn't kiss your mom on the lips after what she does. You know what I'm saying?
You're trying to piss me off. You're trying to piss me off.
Deep. That's what she wanted me to do.
Nobody wanted you to do that. I think you're making this up. I think you have this fantasy life that you think this is all just a big game. It's not real life. You don't even think this is real life, do you?
I'm not really sure. I think we're like a reflection of vibrations, and those vibrations are affected by other things. And then, you know, I think the better you're connected with that, the more you can play the banjo, the more better, you know? So
it all has to do with their banjo.
I'm pretty sure it does.
Hi, Pastor Hills.
Hi.
Consistency here. You are a genius.
Thank
you. Viewers will easily skyrocket with Chris Jericho on the program. Scuffed Chris Jericho, scuffed Chris Jericho.
His name's not Chris Jericho.
Chris Jericho, scuffed Chris Jericho.
His name is not Chris Jericho. Chris Jericho. Stop calling him Chris Jericho.
I mean, like, CJ is cool. I'm playing CJ's on May 11th, so.
It's insulting. It's insulting that they keep calling you because we need to get famous. Like I said, this is all part of the deal.
Hey, I've thought of it before. CJ also be circle jerk.
Show? Why are you doing
You should be on my
show?
Christianity hotline doing the thumb shaker with me, your
don't,
son Bill.
Don't say the C word on my program. You're not working with any J word or C word show, are you?
I know what that said. Was it? What did it say?
They're saying that you look like Jesus. The J word.
I get that a lot. You know, like, people worship me sometimes. It's cool. I don't mind.
How is well, that? Are you a cult? Are you Jim Jones?
Nah, I think I'm too humble to say that I would be or wouldn't be because then I would, you know?
You really give me, like, satanic, like, cult vibes right now.
Nah, man. We just, like, have, like, a
I don't
nice,
know, man. I
like,
don't
like,
know, man.
Like, you know, maybe, like, some pasta on Sunday and some salad and stuff's pretty good.
I don't know because you're giving me some really, really you creepy know. Vibes right now. I'm very uncomfortable right now.
I imagine you tossed a salad on Sunday before.
So I don't even know what that means because I'm not addicted to sex. Is that about sex?
Hello? I'm just saying. Hello?
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 Yeah. Hi, how are
that
you
Buddha
doing,
was that?
Doing tonight?
I'm sure you're used to gagging on your throat. Hello? It's not funny.
Hi. How are you gentlemen doing tonight?
Well, I'm frustrated because we've had a massive technical problem earlier tonight on the program. It's Chad. Apparently... ordered the wrong we have Spectrum and they're terrible and then the other thing here is Steve is just I don't know what happened. He was on a good course and now he's been like sounding like he's like Bill Nye the Science Guy but high or something or like
I don't think I'm really like a scientist, you know, like I'd be a scientist but then you got to get the coat. I don't really know where you get the coat
science
from.
Is it real?
I mean, you could like go to Party science City and you could real. Get a coat, but like people are going to be like, "Hey, that's a Party City coat." So I don't know if this dude's a real scientist or not. And then like get like a pen protector, but who uses a pen anymore? You know what I mean?
Well, it's very unfortunate, but I just wanted to say less Buddha as well, but I do relate to one of the callers. I did try and butt-fuck a Gila monster one time.
I'm sorry? Say that one more time?
A Gila monster?
Yes, I tried to butt-fuck a Gila monster.
You tried to butt... What are you saying to me in plain English right now on a Buddhism hotline for a children
I don't
on
know.
Television?
I don't know what a Gila
Am
monster
is. Am I hearing this correctly?
Is that a Disney?
Well, I mean, if the other caller said it's okay to buck an orangutan...
What are you saying? Hang up the call!
I don't really know what a Gila monster is.
You're entertaining
this. Here's the thing. Like, I'm not a veterinarian. You know, I mean, you could probably use the same jacket. But again, I don't know, man. It may be cool to be called Dr. Banjo. That might be kind of cool. But, you know, then you have, like, all these animals and stuff. And then it starts to smell bad. You know, like... I don't know. I mean, people are gross,
Every
too. So I don't know if I want to be a doctor either.
It's just your opinion, man.
I don't understand what that said.
It's not my opinion. No, they're saying that. First of all, it's not an opinion. I wrote two award-winning books. you're sitting behind a keyboard typing right now that I didn't write two award-winning books. Okay, I'm not a fraud. I'm not a fraud. I am not a god, but I am an influential figure in the Buddhism religion. I'm a very influential figure in the religion of Buddhism. And I'm not doing this for profit. I'm not doing this for gain. But a pastor needs a private jet to get around. A pastor needs to have nice things. Okay? A pastor deserves to have.
I like cows like to be on a pasture, you know? So, because then they can, like, eat grass and stuff. Wait, is that a person?
We're gonna fuck you up. We're gonna... What?
Oh, it's Lombowski.
Who is Lombowski?
Your opinion, man.
It's your opinion, man. Yeah.
What is this guy on drugs, too?
I mean, he, I mean, he is, but.
Oh, my Buddha, he looks like you, I think.
I get a lot of that, you know.
Why are they trying to figure you out?
I think it's because there's, like, a general, like, consensus that people just, like, you know, I hang out with that dude, you know what I mean? Like, you bring me to the party, man, I might eat some of your shrimp and stuff, just kind of hang out, but, you know. At least I ain't gonna, you know, like break your TV or something, you know. But I mean, maybe, yeah, I did throw something at a TV once. I threw a beer at a wall one time, and then my daughter went and said that to school, and that sounded kind of bad. But the Buccaneers had missed a field goal, so I threw the beer because they had missed. This is not the first time, and then like, so that was kind of disappointing. How's it going, caller?
Hello.
Okay, so. I just heard you say that he wrote two award-winning books, but you did write a book, but you won no awards on that because they're dog shit.
I thought about writing a book.
Okay.
You know?
Let me tell you something. Where is it at?
Be like called...
By the way, Chad, he just swore, so bleep him out, please.
The book of BS is what I was thinking.
This is a real book. It's looking at you right now. Buddha bless me. Buddha bless you. Okay, this is a real book. A lot of people bought it. It did very well. It went all across the world.
The book is real.
Look it up on Google right now. Look it up on Google. Goggle it right now. Goggle it right now. Look at the reviews. They're 5-star reviews.
I've seen some videos where they wear goggles. But like,
National Buddhism Association, I did win an award.
They take the lens out of the goggles, so it's just like a goggle frame.
Show us the award.
You know what I mean?
If you have them, show us.
Well, I don't have it with me right now, but it's... To
be honest, it's kind of like me saying I'm a professional athlete, despite the fact I'm not. Like, how do you prove I'm not a professional athlete?
Why would I have an incentive? Why would I have an incentive to lie? That makes no sense.
You've won no award. Okay. Show us the video. Will be a photo of you. No award because you're so prideful about your awards. You should have like a picture of you receiving them.
Okay, fine. I'll give me like a week.
Yeah, he's got plenty of pictures of him receiving
and
stuff.
I'll get mine. I'll get my award. I mean, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's no problem. I can do that. That's no problem.
Okay, yeah, show us the award.
I will show you the award, and I'm going to get that award. And you know what? Why don't you mind your own business? Because I have enough Karens watching this program that want to be up in my business. Okay? You are not me. You don't have to deal with...
I can see why all your marriages failed.
Oh, why my marriages failed? Now you want to get personal around. You know, yeah, Katie Hills cheated on me.
Katie,
she cheated on me.
They all failed.
No, she cheated on me. Because he said it wasn't big enough. Because I chopped my genitalia off. Because I don't want to have sexual contact because I'm a Buddhist. TV. I told her I'm a Buddhist. She didn't listen to me. I don't want to be in a marriage anyways. Buddhists are minimalism. We don't believe in marriage.
Yeah, it's good to keep things simple sometimes. You know,
like, bigger is better. I don't care what they say. I think smaller is better. I think smaller is better. I think smaller is better. I think smaller is better.
You know how many co-hosts you have, and none of them are there?
I mean, I feel like Needles is like, smaller ones would be better, so there's some truth to that.
You guys have not won any awards. Why don't you guys make a book and then start talking
to me?
If you haven't wrote a book, then I don't want to hear it.
I'm just saying, like, you know.
Hello? Hello?
You get one of those tetanus shots or whatever. What's the one when you're going to step on a screw so you don't get tetanus shot?
That's called the AIDS shot, I think.
I don't know.
I think it's the AIDS one.
It might be.
Hello? Hello? You're in the Buddhism Hotline with Banjo Steve and Jonathan Hills. Hello? Can you hear me, caller? Caller? Hello? Caller, I can hear something. You're kind of talking right now. Can you try talking again?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Guess what? Your phone's broken. Their phone's broken. Don't call into this program unless your phone works.
Years ago, our Nana was trained in the ways of magic. Her classmate, Kong Lee, defied her destiny and unleashed the power of a magical cookbook.
Nana stopped him. The pages of the book were scattered. Now Kong Lee is back to recover the pages.
What Anna is on this program right now? Stop putting shit on my program. You see that? Sexual. It's all sexual. Everything's sexual. You know what I mean?
I don't know, man. I was just thinking,
what's up, Wesley? How you doing, buddy?
That's not my name.
I'm going to go for a swim.
Happy belated birthday.
That's not my name.
Hey, what's that chick's name next to you? Because, I mean, to be honest, she looks kind of rough. I ain't even going to lie to you, man.
Yeah.
Well, it's not a woman. I was actually bamboozled.
Yeah.
Oh, you were bamboozled. Well, how? Because, how are you bamboozled?
Because his band person told me a woman was going to come on tonight's program.
My publicist probably did that.
I don't even know if it's a real publicist.
Yeah.
She's like, if you go on this show, you can talk about your album. And I was like, well, I guess I got nothing else to do.
No free shout out.
Not right now. I mean, they're not picking me up till 8 o'clock. So I'm just like, I'm just riding it out.
What's your name?
Banjo Steve.
Banjo with an E. Banjo
Steve. Listen, yeah. My name's Duke. How are you doing? Listen, I'm going to give you some free advice. Don't drink or eat anything that Wesley gives you. He will try to take your beehole to Pound Town.
No, okay?
I figured out when I walked in.
Hold on a second.
This looks like either a low cost, like... porn scene, or definitely it's got a very rape dungeon kind of vibe. So, you know, I was thinking right off the bat, you know, I even tried not to touch too many items while in here, you know.
I get it.
So,
I get it.
And then I called a couple of people to tell them I was at this location.
If you give you anything that says green tea on it, he's going to try to tongue punch your fart box. So you need to be careful.
Well, I might welcome that. I mean, you know, not because of, like,
that.
I mean, not in a gay way, but kind of like just a, hey, I appreciate you coming on the show kind of thing, you know?
Well, I just want to keep an eye out on you.
You know,
I mean, you seem like a good guy. And,
I appreciate that. You know,
Shut the hell up.
Shut the hell up yourself.
I did say that. I just said I'm going to get in your face now. I'm going to get in your face.
That's the reason why you're born with a small penis, because you're angry all the time.
First of all, the smaller is the better. The smaller is the better. The bigger stuff is male toxicity. The bigger it is, it's male toxicity. I cut my genitalia off, and I know you're Deuce 03. I know you're Deuce 03. I'm not stupid. Oh, I hope he got off the air. Is he off the air, Chad? Good. 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 Get him off the program. I don't need him on this program. I don't need him on this program. Get him off.
Man, it seems like all I got in my news feed is like slap fights nowadays.
What does that have to do with Buddhism?
Well, they smack him in the face, and then the other person gets to smack them in the face, and then sometimes they fall over, and then sometimes they yell, and then they smack the other person.
Bless Buddha.
What?
So. Hello, Condom Fong. Can I ask for a prayer?
Yeah.
My sister is having a kid. I'm going
Condom
to be a
father. Phone?
Could you pray for us?
Absolutely. Did you say you're... Okay. Buddha, we play that biggest dickest... Big us... How do you pronounce that? I'm sorry. I don't want to mess that up. Biggest dickest says his sister is having a kid. Congratulations. Buddha, we ask that the child that biggest dickest has with this woman, his sister... and he's the father. He's a lucky father to be. Wait a second. Is that an incest?
What is that?
Is that an incest?
I wasn't really listening.
Hold on. He said he had. He said his sister is pregnant, and he's the father.
Is that what it said? Cause
did you put your genitalia in your own sister?
Yeah, you're not supposed to do that.
No.
No.
No, you're not supposed to do that, Steve. No. So. No. No.
Yeah.
No, you might be going to hell for that. You might actually be going to hell for that. That's bad. That's really bad. That's like really, really bad, actually. That's really bad, Steve.
They say you're not supposed to, so. I mean, I wouldn't do what someone else told me to do it, but I wouldn't do that to prove them wrong. That's just pretty lucky.
There's
you know.
A lot of evil lurking on this program tonight. I don't know what energy you're bringing into this because there's.
I don't think it's me. I think maybe this the yin and the yang. You know, if I bring the light, then they got the dark, and the dark's got the light. Well, it's like this, you know, manifestal bouncing.
I don't know what's going on tonight, but this show has been off the rails. What's going on, Jay Diddy? What's going on there, Banjo Steve? How you doing tonight, Diddy?
Yo, what up? Hey, y'all coming out to the show, 420 Fest.
What is a 420 Fest?
Hey, it's Saturday.
Hey, so when you gonna come to Detroit, there, pimp, so I can give you the red carpet at the Buddhism Palace in Detroit, Michigan.
This guy is a fake mayor of Detroit. Don't listen to anything he has to say. He's a fake mayor of Detroit.
I've been to Detroit. Yo, what's up? Shout out to St. Andrews Hall, man. What's up? I played there.
There you go.
No shout outs.
Detroit.
No shout outs.
That's right. Detroit. 313. Is that the air code?
Detroit is the ghetto.
313.
Oh, it was ghetto as fuck, man. It was ghetto as fuck.
Hold on, everyone there.
Little Taylor, Michigan for you guys, man.
Shout out to for doing this thing. Stop hating. And another thing, hey, Jonathan, did you ever read that person's name called Biggus Dickus?
Why are you laughing at me right now? Why are you laughing?
Dude, the man's name was Biggus Dickus. So that means that he had a big.
I've been called that before.
He had a big for your mouth.
Punks have nothing better to do with their time. These punks have nothing better to do with their time.
Hey, shut up. Anyway, shout out to all the pimps, players, ballers, hustlers, and shot callers in the chat room. This is your main man, the mayor of Detroit. Hey, Jonathan, when you going to have me on your show? Come on your show, Jonathan?
Never stepping foot in my premises unless you're going to go to the pound town. Or I'm sorry, go to jail. Go to jail.
Hey, you want to take me to Pound Town?
No, I'm not. I'm in Pound Town. I said Pound to jail.
This guy might be gay. He's the one who said he's not gay. If you want to get someone gay,
go with this guy. I'm not gay. He's probably going to do anything for $5. Sucky. $5. I'm not going to do it. I'm a Buddhist.
I'm not.
Hey, go back, Ellie.
I wish I was. That'd be cool.
You just look like you came back with a back, Ellie.
You know. Be easier,
Jonathan. What do you think about Biggus Dickus? What do you think about Biggus Dickus coming on your show?
I think whoever put that on the air is childish. And you know what? I don't think in the gutter. So the reason I didn't know that was because I don't have a mind like a 5-year-old disgusting sexual monster.
Oh, shit. That.
No, I didn't get trolled. I did not get trolled. I knew what was.
You did get trolled. You got made a fool out of it. Hey, I'm coming on your show real soon there, Jonathan.
No, you ain't. You're not coming on here unless you want to get arrested.
Yes, I am.
Not unless you want to get arrested.
Yes, no, I won't get arrested.
Not unless you want to get arrested.
No, I won't. And guess who invited me on your show?
Nobody can invite you on my program except me.
King Chang invited me on the show.
No, he doesn't like your kind. No, he doesn't like your kind. It's impossible. He doesn't like people like you.
Hold on.
What?
Oh, you're being racist.
No, I'm not being racist. No. Hold on a second.
Yeah, that is racist. What's my kind?
Ching Chong doesn't like people that are darker in complexion because...
Hold on.
It's a religion. It's a culture thing. It's a Chinese culture thing. It's not racist.
I like Chinese food.
It's a Buddhist culture. It's a Buddhist culture. And like I said
before... No, it's not Buddhist culture. Hold on.
I like the bourbon chicken.
I'm not racist.
Bourbon chicken is pretty good.
You had a Buddhist who had a festival with penises.
No, I did not say that. I did not say that,
and
though.
Biggest dickest for your mouth.
God, shut him off already. What are you doing, Chad? Shut him off. Thank Buddha. You guys need to find better things to do with your life. You need to find
Yeah.
What?
Oh, I don't know. I just think I got to take a leak, man.
Go ahead. Do it right now. I know you want to. Do it right now.
In the studio?
Yeah, right there. Right there. Right there.
I don't know if you really want me to or not.
I just
want
to see if you're loyal to me. If I ask you to do it, will you do it?
I'll piss on you.
Oh, I'm not gay.
Oh, I didn't think it was a gay thing.
That's gay. That is definitely gay.
I just was trying to improve overall smell. Hey, I'll be right back. I gotta go call my publicist real quick. See if this is still a... Jesus Christ.
No, that's a good idea.
This show takes a long time. I'll be right back.
You're going to make a lot of money, though. You remember that. We're going to make a lot of money together. Good contract. Split 70-30. 70... Okay, I just want to say something right now. I don't know what the boot has been going on tonight. This has been a train wreck. I admit that. It's been an absolute train wreck. But I thought a woman was coming on the program tonight. I did not know I was going to get this tonight. Okay, I did not have any idea. I'm not clickbaiting, guys. I'm not scuffed. I didn't do anything. They messed the internet up. I can't control the internet. And I'm a Buddhist. We got about 20 more minutes left on this program tonight. 20 more minutes on the program. And I want to see the most serious tone for the rest of this program. So if you have any final donations on the program tonight or calls on the program tonight, right now is the final time. What are you doing? What is that noise?
Oh. I was just like, you know. So,
hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Hey, what's up,
Colin? Yes, sir, on the Buddhism Hotline. This is Jonathan Hill.
I want to say a starfish fits really good up my shit pipe.
Okay, now it's the same guy, Chad. Why aren't you tracking these calls? It's the same guy.
That's what's going on.
It's the same guy. It's the same person every single time. He's just talking about having astral contact with animals and stuff. The Buddha is going on.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi, is this Banjo I'm talking to? Is this Banjo?
Yeah. Banjo, what's
Banjo,
up?
Banjo Steve is his name.
Yeah, I'm good.
Banjo with an E.
I've been a fan of the show since 2019. I have a question for you. Can you please grab a Buddha statue and shove it in your asshole? I want you to have sex the 69 blowjob with Wesley. Do it for me, please.
Where is your mother at?
I couldn't quite understand the question.
He's talking about oral sex.
How a blowjob. Banjo, Wesley have a blowjob together. 69.
Shut him off. Shut him off.
I don't get it. I mean, there's a plethora of pornography you can watch.
Are you promoting this? Are you promoting this? You want to become a sex star or a Buddhist country star or a Buddhist singer?
I was what was the question?
Have you sold your morals? Do you have any moral compass guiding you?
I mean, if I try to use a compass, I'd get confused because, like, it says you're going to the North Pole.
Would you do a blowjob for $1 million?
Nah, probably not. Are you offering me that?
No, I'm not. Well, I'm testing
you. I'm going to need to see the money first.
I'm testing you right now. Because you're cracking under stress. You crack really easily. You've been cracking.
Nah.
You've been really...
Bless Buddha.
You just seem suspicious.
No more jokes.
Thank you.
Time for a serious Buddhism debate.
Thank you.
Steve, Jonathan, pay attention.
Okay.
The Rock or Stone Cold Steve Austin. Both wrestlers have supreme accolades, with The Rock being a celebrity. But wrestler-wise, I gotta give it to Austin 316.
And I have to give it to shut up. Okay? Because WWE is gay. They're touching each other's butts. They're in tight underwear.
I don't think I understand the question. Is that a question or a statement?
No, it's not a question.
I was watching this wrestling match, and this one dude put his nuts in this other dude's face.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. See, we can actually agree with something for once.
Remember the face rake? You know, they'd rake the face. I always figured was kind of brutal.
Each face. Yes, no,
rake with a K. Rake.
What do you put on your beard?
It just does its thing. You know, man, I'm pretty low maintenance. You know, I like to keep my sack nice and clean.
It makes you look smart, but you're not smart. That's the problem. It doesn't really make sense.
Well, you know.
It makes you look smart. Do you have glasses or something, too, that you wear?
I mean, I got sunglasses.
Well, no, I'm talking about actual glasses.
I don't know where you buy them from.
Are you homeless?
No.
Do you have a home?
I do have a home.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Is it a seven, is it the back alley?
By I actually pretty fortunate. I got a nice house and a studio, and I get to do my thing. And then, you know, I travel around playing shows, and then my post is like, hey, there's this show. And, you know, she's like, it's a little silly, and it's kind of stupid, and the host is a little, you know, cheap and whatnot. And it's like, but, you know, they got some loyal fans out there might dig you. I'm like, I just say, all right, I'll go see what's up to them, you know.
You're just using me.
You know, I mean, I kind
of. You're using me. You're using me.
I've been called that before. I've been called a narcissist because I don't care, but, you know, I can pretend to care pretty good, so that seems like almost fair.
I feel like you don't even care, do you? You just came on here to get fame.
Well, I mean, but pretty much, yeah.
Really?
Well, I mean, not
really?
more than I already have, so that would be some. So some is better than none, so, you know. Yeah, and that's why they got nuns and priests and stuff, you know, but they ain't got that in the Buddhist. So, you know, we just kind of do a thing.
I don't give a Buddha at all about me. I feel like you don't give a Buddha.
I mean, probably not.
Wear flip-flops on this program. I told you to wear a suit.
Yeah, and I was like, I ain't wearing a suit for that garbage television show. I was like, but I got a collar on my shirt, so that seems like pretty good. You know, it's efforted, you know.
Bless Buddha. You're
Dance Mutant. Fucking dance, you toxic rat-faced streetwalker.
What are you? What did you just call me? What did you just call me? I do not look like a rat. The last thing I... What is this song? What you know the song. What is this song?
That's why the microphone smells. I knew there was a reason why the microphone's gross.
Like how jerky this song is, and I'm like how jerky it is. I feel like it's like hot, stressing me out. Stressing, it's giving me a seizure again. Like these loud sounds. I don't know why you're so chill about everything. It's like you're.
Well, you know.
Doesn't even bother you at all.
Oh, we just kind of do a thing, man. You know, and then, you know. That's just kind of how it is, and collars they call, and collars they shot call. You know, I was thinking about that.
Bless Buddha.
Back in the day when
you
it had
Banjo
like.
Banjo Kazooie, just so you know, you're sitting next to a pedophile. That's like fucking little kids.
You know, you get that kind of vibe when you walk in here.
That is an easy thing to throw out right now. First of all, you just swore, so that invalidates everything you just said. You just swore on my program. That invalidates.
Something.
My name is Jonathan Ellis, and I support CP. CP.
No, he means something.
I love CP.
That. I don't know you.
CP is that means.
I don't know.
It's not what you think.
Or not family.
It's not what you think. I can explain.
But you know what
I can explain everything.
You're sitting with my family.
I can explain everything right now.
Smelling like
Steve,
a fucking
I can explain
rat.
Everything right now.
And you know
there's
what
a
I
perfectly
do? Fucking rat.
Valid explanation
I'll
for this right now. You know I have PTSD. My name is Jonathan Ellis, and I support
you. You know
CP.
I have PTSD
you
for
know,
that.
He means something.
I love
that.
You know I have PTSD for that. I was shot in the chest.
Yeah.
I was shot in the chest 5 years ago, and they.
Wait, that was you?
Yes, that was me. Yes, that was me. I was shot in the chest by a man that's crazy as a Mormon. He's a Mormon.
I wasn't really paying attention.
I know you're not because you're on drugs. You're high right now. You've
been man.
You
I just
care about me. You don't care about this program. You're just here for money. You're just here for fame. You don't give a Buddha what's going on. You don't care that I just said I support CP, which, by the way, I don't. All right, support cheese pizza. I don't support cheese pizza.
Ah, cheese pizza.
Cheese pizza. That's what I was. But I don't. Actually
cheese pizza is pretty good.
I take that back. I don't.
I like it with toppings, and then sometimes I like it without toppings, and then sometimes
you
a variety
just
of toppings.
You're validating my feelings right now.
You know, like if you had a
validating me.
You know.
Completely invalidating.
I like anchovies on them sometimes, you know.
Completely invalidating.
Is that CAP? I don't know. It's
very invalidating.
Cheesy anchovy pizza. Yeah, that could be.
Doesn't even care.
Be an alphabetical ACP, but no one's going to know what you're talking
care.
About.
No. He doesn't even give a Buddha, does he? He doesn't give a Buddha, does he? You don't give a single Buddha, do you?
I mean, you know, that's, yeah, sure.
Don't you look up to me at least as a role model or something?
I mean, like, like vertically, I kind of look down at you because you're kind of like a little bitch. So,
what did you just say?
I said I kind of look down at you when I talk to you because, you know, maybe not because you're like, you know, your statute is.
In a position of power. I'm gonna say that one more time. You think because you're bigger than me that you could take me? I'll tell you what right now. I'll tell you something right now. I will make you change your whole life. I will control you. I'm not going to do it in a bad way. I'm going to do it in a good
way. I don't want a relationship.
No, I'm not asking for a relationship. I'm saying that I am going to guide you, your career, your life.
Yeah, this is a legacy. Guide thing I was concerned about.
I am going to be Banjo Steve. I am the Banjo Steve.
You are.
Jonathan Hills has always been Banjo Steve.
Who's Jonathan Hills?
I made you. I'm making you right now. If you listen to me, if you follow me, I will make you Krypton. I will make you the next Elvis, but Buddhist. I will make you the next lead winning, award winning song artist that's a Buddhist. I will make you go famous. I will make you go off the charts. But you have to give it up for me. You have to submit to me. You have to submit to me. Be submissive. I want you to be submissive.
Yeah, I'm probably not going to do that.
Serious?
Like, you know, because I mean, I'm thinking, you know, like, what do I want to do? Like, rise up to the level of living in your trailer? I mean, come on.
It's not a trailer. It's a mobile home.
Like, I already have a better house than you right now.
It's a luxury mobile home.
And, like, I'm not even trying to brag. Like, that's the worst part. I'm going, man, I got a shitty house, but in your place.
You just said the S word.
I said city house. I have a city house in a city. You know.
You should.
It's, like, in comparison to this place. It's like
a luxury.
You know how you like feel good and humble because you see someone in the street sleeping on the street, and you're like, I'm glad I don't gotta do that tonight. And then I come here, and I'm gonna go home and be like, I'm glad I ain't gotta do that tonight. So that's pretty cool, you know. Like, it'll make me feel good.
It's a luxury mobile home.
I mean, I don't know about luxury. Like, I mean. All right, so, like, if you were in a country where people were, like, really, really poor.
Here he goes again.
And, like, you know, maybe they're, like, I don't know. Maybe it's, like, something better than a cardboard box, but, like, not. Those people might be, like, kind of impressed, you know. Like, they'd be like, oh, he's got electricity. That's impressive. Well, I think most people are just going to be like, nah, that's all right, you know. It's not really my thing, you know. So. Is it 8 o'clock yet, man? I mean,
you're a disappointment. You're never gonna make it in Hollywood. You're never gonna make it in Hollywood.
Well, that's all right, man.
No, you're probably gonna have an overdose. Probably gonna overdose.
I doubt that. You know, I have a pretty good time, man.
Takes.
You know,
you don't have what it takes.
I mean, I'm already.
You don't have what it takes.
I'm already doing it. You know.
You don't have what it takes to be the next Buddhist celebrity. You don't have what it takes.
I mean,
I know talent when I see talent. You're not talent. You're no talent.
Yeah,
I didn't think you were that good, honestly. I was just saying that.
Yeah, you know that.
No, I don't.
Well.
I don't. No, I don't. I think you're the next failed, washed-up celebrity.
I think so, because I think I'm already, like, kind of, like, doing my thing, and then, you know.
But nobody knows you.
What do you mean?
Nobody
you know me.
Banjo Steve.
They know me. What's up, people? They know me. See? I already know. Let me tell you.
Why are you positive out of me? Why are you doing positive out of me?
When I walk into a club or a venue and I start hearing people yell out, Banjo Steve, Banjo Steve. Man, I that's the only validation I need because I do it for those folks, you know. Like, I don't do it for, you know, people in a cheap suit in a shitty studio. You kind of. Just, you know, I think
you're a narcissist.
Huh?
I think that you're a sociopath.
I've been called that.
I think you're a sociopath.
Yeah, there was a time period I was called that and a psychopath, like, repeatedly on, like, multiple occasions by different people. And I'm like, I don't think that's true. But then I did want to get revenge. But then I was like, I ain't got time to do that, you know. I'm pretty busy, man. I play franchise mode on Madden, and that takes a lot of time, dude. You got draft playbook, and you know, and then you got to get like a playbook. You like, hey, what's up, caller? How's it going?
They're against Buddhism.
Who is?
Video games are against the religion.
What up?
Hello. Hello?
Yo, what's up, John?
Jonathan, it's Jonathan.
And I'm sorry, what's up, Jonathan?
I'm nothing's up. I'm just here.
Hey, you, and who's that, Banjo Kazooie?
It's a person that is has failed.
Banjo Steve.
I decide that I don't want to work with anymore. I'm not going to work with your record label. Unless you apologize to me.
I have one question, though.
That's all you
do. Yo, what's the question?
Apologize to me. Immediate.
Let's see what his question is first.
Yo, John, I have one question.
It's Jonathan, please.
All right, well, okay, Jonathan, I have one question.
What is your question?
All right, so here's the thing. I want to convert to Buddhism because I just saw, I'm baffled how the fuck you managed to resurrect Kurt Cobain. I hats off to you, man, for that.
I really like that.
This is... You know what? He probably likes being called Kurt Cobain at this point. Seems like he likes being called Kurt Cobain. You know why? Because he probably worships the devil. Yeah. I honestly think his band is a devil worshiping band.
I mean, he's a Pisces. I'm a Pisces. You know, we both do our thing. And, you know, so that's kind of how it goes.
I think he worships the devil. That's what I think. I think he worships the devil.
I really don't got time to do that because, I don't got, like, a suit. And, like, you got to do, like, sacrifices and stuff. I don't know where you get a goat from. Like, where the fuck do you get a goat from?
You just swore!
Well, I mean, all right, where do you get a goat from? You know what I mean? Collar? I couldn't hear you over his crying.
You never find somebody that wants to work with me, that actually cares about me, that has any feelings for me. I feel like everybody just wants to use me. Everyone just wants to use me for my Buddhist clout. Nobody cares about me.
Yo, you have no Buddhist clout.
I have Buddhist clout, actually. I'm famous.
You have clout for a rat-faced motherfucker. Oh, Buddhism clout. The Mickey Mouse over here.
This has been a disappointment of a program. It's been a disappointment. You were never a woman. You lied to me. I shouldn't have to pay you anything. You lied to me.
Bless Buddha.
I don't really need money,
Jonathan,
man.
Jonathan, open your eyes. He's using you. He know nothing about Buddhism, the Dharma wheel, the Eightfold Path, the Middle Way, or the Noble Truths. I wouldn't be surprised if he was a WWE wrestler. It's time to vacate him from the program.
Cool.
What are the four noble truths? Go ahead.
What's that?
We got a few minutes here. What are the four noble truths if you're actually a Buddhist? What are the four noble truths in order? Go.
Well, there's noble crust. And there is. Like, if you have an issue at a restaurant and, like, they comp you, then you got no bill. So that's the second one.
No.
And then. No. And then the other day, I was like, hey, do you know William? I'm like, William? Oh, you mean, do you know Bill? I was like, all right, well, that's the third one, no Bill. And then, like, a duck was, like, eating a firecracker, and it blew off. And people were like, hey, dude, that duck's got no Bill. You know what I mean? So that's four right there.
I think you're foolish. I think you're absolutely foolish. I think you've been foolish this whole time. You know what? I think you're this whole time. I think you came here tonight to take advantage of me.
I mean, I'm in. I'm feeling like kind of like this.
You thought I was stupid, didn't you? You thought you could walk right over me and make a fool out of me.
Well,
you thought you could make a fool out of me.
What I think and what I know are almost two different complete perceptions.
You're not Einstein, okay? Stop with this philosophy thing. You're not a genius. You're not.
Well, I mean, I know the E minor played twice is pretty cool.
I think you're absolutely full of it. I think you're a fraud. I think you are a liar, Banjo Steve. I think you're a liar, and I think you should apologize to me.
I've been called a liar a bunch of times before, but
I think you should apologize to me.
That feels truthful to say. So then that kind of contradicts.
Are you going to apologize to me?
For what?
For making a fool out of me, for embarrassing me, for saying you're a woman.
Well, I'm really had to work very hard at that. That's just kind of like you being you and, you know, the show being the show. That's just.
You need to apologize. Yeah, my feelings have been hurt tonight.
Yeah, your feelings get hurt, you know, and that's That's what happens.
That's all.
But in the same perspective, there's a reality in which your feelings weren't hurt, and you just happen to be in this one. How can I control that? You know, I'm not a full maestro. I'm just a dude on a carpet flying through the universe, man.
What the hell are you talking about? You've not made any sense this whole program. You've been talking out of your butt for 2 hours.
Nah, man. You watch it later. You get some notes down.
You're foolish. And honestly, like I said before, I don't know if I want to work with you on this record deal. I think I want to back out right now. I think I want to back out of the record deal.
Well, that's good. Work with someone else. There's no real deal I want to do with you.
You're not upset about that?
Nah. I'll be all right. You know, because there's a reality in which there is a deal and there's one where there isn't. And this happens to be the one where there isn't.
Isn't the Matrix?
I'm cool with that.
This isn't the Matrix.
It is the Matrix. It's all the Matrix. Everything we do is the Matrix.
What the hell are you talking?
We're all AI generated. We just think we're our own reality. We've already been created, and now we're just riding through this manifestation. So
are you even real?
I don't know. For every option, there's a different variation. And every variation, there's another option. You know what I mean?
I feel something, so you must be real.
Well, that would be the spaceship.
What are you? You're on drugs. No, you are on drugs.
I'm sure there's a reality in which one in which I am and one in which I am not.
People who do drugs are not welcome in my program. People who do.
Yeah, I'm not on them, so that works out good for.
What do you mean you're on? You're on the program right now.
Oh, all right. Well, that works out good for me too.
No, I'm saying that people, you're not welcome here. Is what I'm saying.
Do I get paid more after 8 o'clock?
No, I'm kicking you out.
Oh.
I'm kicking you out.
I don't know. My ride just said they're going to be here in a few minutes. So, yeah.
No, I'm kicking you out. You don't understand. I'm kicking you out. Aren't you mad about that?
No. Because, you know, there's probably reality where I might be mad, but this ain't that reality. Like, we were talking about Chinese food earlier, and I think that'd be pretty good, you know.
You don't even give a Buddha.
You can get like an egg roll and then like, maybe some sweet and sour chicken would be pretty good.
What the hell are you talking about Chinese people for now?
Why
are you talking about Chinese people?
Well, they got some fortune cookies that are pretty good sometimes.
What are you talking about, Steve?
You know, like, but you got to say in bed afterwards for it to, like, manifest. So, well, Banjo Steve, that's a banjo with an E for you and me. Because I play everything. I'm eclectic, eccentric, energetic, entertaining, and you might envy me, but that's okay, because, you know, I don't mean to be your god, but if you worship me, I worship you back.
And he's a fraud, he's a liar.
That's not true. But Cash App and Venmo, Banjo Steve with an E, you can always put donations to the cause in that. And then
no, there's no shout outs on this program. There's no shout outs.
I wasn't shouting out. I was just kind of talking.
There's no shout-outs on this program. You've just been using me this whole time for my clout. It's obvious. Everyone knows. Everyone sees it on this program. You've been here the whole time because you want to suck off my Buddhist clout. You want to suck up my Buddhist clout. You just want to use me to get famous and then do your thing. You know what? I am not going to be sucked off. I'm refusing to be sucked off tonight. I'm refusing to be sucked off tonight.
That's going to work out real good.
No, I'm leaving in protest.
All right.
I'm leaving in protest right now. I'm leaving. How do you feel about that, huh?
I mean, I'm pretty good with it.
Frustrated. No, I'm frustrated. That's a frustration. It's not weird. You're making it weird. You made it weird. This whole it's a frustration thing. Okay?
I see that. It's very, very frustrating.
I'm walking out in protest.
Should I just walk out?
No, I'm walking out. That way it looks like that I chose to leave and you didn't.
Well, I gotta walk out anyways. I ain't staying in this rape dungeon any longer.
Okay, so what do you say? Okay, fine. You know what? Yeah, I'm kicking you out. Get out.
All right, I'll see you later.
Wait, you don't even care? You're just gonna walk right out?
About what?
I'm kicking you out.
Show's over, man.
You're not mad at me?
Why would I be mad?
Okay, fine. Leave then. Fine. I don't even care.
All right.
I don't even care anyway.
I'll see you guys later.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. I didn't want him here anyways.
I just leave my garbage here.
You have to pay me. You show my stuff out. You leave this place like a dump. It's a $1 million studio. $1 million studio. You know what? The program is over tonight. You know why? Because Chad lied to me. Chad lied to me. I thought I was getting someone on this program tonight. That was a serious Buddhist musician, and I was going to take him to Hollywood, and we're going to become famous together. But I was lied to. You all saw it tonight. I was lied to, guys. I was lied to. I was deceived, and I was tricked. I am a victim, as always. He said there was supposed to be a woman co-host. It wasn't a woman co-host, was it? It wasn't a woman co-host, was it? It never is. It never is. And Chad can't even get the internet to work correctly. He can't even do his job. So none of this works. No, this is all. It's always been your guys' fault. This is always your guys' fault. You guys are the catalyst to all these issues. You think it's funny watching me fail this train wreck of a program? Why don't you go find something better to do with your time? Because the program's over. Go watch your Netflix and your Hulu and your little Vadio Goms. Go watch anime and jack off. I don't care. Show's over. Shut it off, Chad. Shut it off. Shut it off.
Hello there. I just wanted to tell you about this amazing program called the Buddhism Hotline. I started watching this Buddhism Hotline during a pretty rough time in my life, and I can comfortably tell you Jonathan has done an amazing job of turning my life around for the better. When I called in, I could tell Jonathan was really hard for me, and that made me even harder for religion and Jonathan. I'm no longer a softie. I'm hard. But the real is, are you hard? Call into the Buddhism Hotline today at 872-287-2800 to convert and change your life for the better. Don't forget, stay hard and Buddha bless.
My name is Jonathan Hills, and I appreciate